Greg Brady with a thyroid problem? You know what I'm talking about? George Clooney, but bigger? You know what I'm talking about? No? Ocean Size 13? Perfect Storm Part 2, how's the weather up there?
There was a time I was, dealing with a lot of rejection. An agent turned me down, and I got the email while I was driving my mom to the airport while she was visiting. That was, and it was like while she was talking about how excited she was for me about, and I didn't want to tell her, so. That was awful. That same week, I, had like two callbacks for a national commercial. Ended up not getting it.
So what have you heard about today's audition? And I'm like, nothing. great to hear. And I'm like, okay, cool. And then he goes, Tom, what we want you to do for this part is we want you to channel your inner cowboy badass. And I got really excited because up until that point, I mentioned earlier I'd lost a lot of weight. The roles I would go out for would be like fat, funny friend. you might date him, but you'd have to talk to him for a while first. That's what I would I was really excited. I was like, this is my moment. And they said they're going to play a song. They're like, Tom, we want you to give us, your inner cowboy badass. So, Harrison, if you could play that track from earlier,
yeah.
And I'll show you guys what I did. And the room just erupted in applause. Thank you, Harrison. Tom, that was exactly what we were looking for. That was perfect. Oh my God, you're a genius. Like, how did we not know? They didn't say that, but I was in my but they're like, so I'm an actor, so I know after an audition, you just get out of there. You don't hang around. It's not a good look as an actor, right? So I get in my car and I drive back. About 20 minutes later, my phone rings. Pick up the phone. It's my agent. He told me that I did a really good job, dancing like a cowboy in front of a room full of adults, that room full of adults wants to give me an opportunity that could change my life. I found out that it was a national commercial that was, obviously, being an actor, I know that means that's going to be played all across the country. I would be able to quit my day job. I could, it was happening. Like, my dream was, happening so quickly, oh my God, I called, I did what any, cowboy badass does at that moment. I picked up the phone, I called my mom. Got this awesome moment with my mom. Called my sister, I called my uncle, I called my best friends, everyone important to me at that point in my life. I called that prick, Jake Marcet from the fourth grade, who said I'd never make it. I was like, guess what, Jake? Guess what, guess who made it? And Jake was like, who is this? I had the jams going, I having so much fun. And I get to my apartment a few hours later, and my phone rings again. My agent, thought he was going to tell me details of going on set because as an actor, I'm on set. I can't be reached because, guys, I'm on set. Hashtag actor's life. So I was getting ready to prepare to get on set. So I'm getting ready for something. Guys, I'm on set. And he actually said, "Sorry, man, we got some bad news." I said, "What's going on? Did they move the set? Like, what's going on?" And he's like, they casted the rest of the commercial, but they cast, everyone else they cast was 5'9" and under. And I was like, okay. They need to replace you. I'm like, but I'm the guy. I'm the main guy. I'm the star. I'm like, yeah, that's true. But not anymore. Because they decided that it'd be much easier to find somebody a bit shorter than you to do pretty much the same thing you did in that room rather than find, a ton of other people to make kills. So they're not going to need you. So I did what any cowboy badass would do in that moment, and I called my mom.
So I was just really, fed up with acting and performing, and I think we all have these moments, but I was sitting here at this table, and I had my tech rehearsal later that night, and I was like, I just don't think I'm going to go. And Aaron was like, what? You're not going to go? And I was like, yeah, what's the point? you know, and I was really kind of, you know, I was really bummed out and wasn't at my best. And she was like, so you're just not gonna do the show, you know? And I was like, no, I'm not, you know? And she's like, so you're just, that's the end of it, huh? You're just gonna no show, and that's the end of, that's how you're gonna go out, huh? And I was like, no, you know, you're right. I'm gonna do the show. But after tomorrow night, you know, I'm probably not.
I'm so glad we're getting in here.
See, I don't even know how to turn the lights on in here.
Do you want me to go into it for the from the queue before that, I guess, going out to sleep tonight?
Sure, why not?
All right, cool. Just to make sure. All right, so.
So I ended up doing it, and, you know, there was a decent amount of people that came, but that was the night that that Arch came. Arch was interested in working with me, and you know, he could help me out for a couple of rehearsals. I almost gave up, yeah, and I don't know what else I'd be doing, you know, like what else, I don't know. I'd probably be like unhappy, you know. I really don't know what I would do to fill up my time. Even if Arch wasn't in the audience, if I just got to do it, I was like, yes, this is what I love to do. This is, you know, this is what makes me happy. I'm not giving up on this.
There you go. And then she goes up here. Come on. There you go. That's Cassie. Yeah. So we've been doing this for a while now. We've been pals, and she's fucking awesome. She's really sweet, and she's like, gets attached to us and stuff. See, yeah. She's like, it's ridiculous. All right, babes, we gotta go. And then you just,
there you go. All right. I really feel like it's kind of like I'm crossing over to a new like place. You know, I feel like it's just, I can't pinpoint like what exactly it means, but I definitely know like all the times when, you know, I you know, traveling by myself, or when there was, you know, one pre-sale at a show, nights like that, when right now going like about to leave for the show, it's all worth it. And I also feel like Sleeping Giant was me specifically embracing my height, and I mean, there's a lot more that I want to embrace, and that I'll still address, you know, I won't shy away from the fact that I'm tall, but I also want to prove I have more to say than just like, hey, I'm tall, but I'm just like you. I want to show that I can, you know, I can do this again and again and again and again.
And then you like cut open the cigar, and you dump all the tobacco in like the garbage and the toilet, or, you know, sometimes just on the floor. And then you take, you know, the reason why we're all here, you know, the weed, right? And you sprinkle that in, you know, and then, you know, you roll it up and you lick it, you know, and then you take your lighter and you burn the bottom of it. And I like to like put it on the oven, you know, the stovetop for a little bit and get it nice and crispy, and, you know, return, yeah. And then I put a little filter in there before I do that, and then I smoke it, and I like feel really, really good, you know? So it's a great process. And I was thinking about it, and that's kind of what I did, you know, over the course of the past 2 years, is I cut myself open, you know, down the middle of the razor blade, and I just let all the things that, you know, weren't serving me, you know, fall out to the ground, and I replaced it with, you know, the things that make me feel good. And I, you know, kind of stitched myself back up. So what I'm saying to you tonight is I'm one big, beautiful blunt. And I am here for you all to pass around and enjoy.
You just can't stop, you know. And I've learned over time that right when you think it's about to end, or there's, you know, it's time to give up, that's the worst time to throw in the towel, because that's when something good's going to happen. But it won't happen if you give up. So if you keep going and pushing through that, that's either when you're going to have a breakthrough yourself, or somebody's going to see you doing your thing, or somebody even will see you struggling and offer help. It's amazing how, you know, you not only will things work out for you if you don't give up, you'll be that person that's telling someone else, like, no, don't let one no or two no's or 10 no's get you to stop doing what you love, because, like, that's the one thing you can control.
Embracing these cliches is the only way I can greet tonight. Because no matter what I do, I'm a giant. And I still gotta sleep tonight.
Oh,